Hezekiah Walker, lift him up. Leap of Faith Show 240-348-1962. We have the author of How Could My Husband Be Gay in the studio today.
Yes.
And, you know, we're just, this is a touchy subject. It's going on in the world. It's going on in the church. It's going on everywhere. So we wanted to touch and weigh in on it. We've been talking about everything, but we want to go into further with Jason on the question that we were discussing earlier is, can you help us to kind of figure out why some gay men keep this as a secret? Why do they get married and have children as a cover-up?
But let me say something. Would it be considered gay, or would it just be considered down low by sexual men? Because normally gay people are already out the closet. So there's a difference between being gay, marrying, versus someone that's on the down low or bisexual or struggling. So, come here, because, you know, I wouldn't want to be classified as a DL man if I'm gay.
Right.
Because to me, that's like, okay, you're disrespecting me because we already out.
Right.
We just waiting for you all to come on out and join the pool.
Well, let's say it this way. Can you explain why some disrespectful, unhonest, untrustworthy men don't tell, because I'm not going to say DL, because some DL men don't want to be called gay because they are on the down low, but they don't get married.
I think part of the issue is that, you know, society forces you to think that being straight is the only way to be, and that it's the right thing to be, and that it's everything. And so when you're struggling with your sexuality and trying to get to a place where you're comfortable with it, it's a very difficult process. And so I think a lot of people succumb to the pressure of feeling that, well, I'm going to do what everybody wants me to do. I'm going to do what makes my family happy. I'm going to do what makes my church happy. I'm going to do what makes my friends happy. And that is get married, which is what I think you're taught growing up in the church. You have to get married, have children, mm-hmm. have a family.
That's the truth.
And I think that the pressure of that mm-hmm. causes people to make decisions that aren't healthy for them, aren't healthy for women, aren't healthy for children. And I think and it's difficult because on one side of it, you tell people you want them to be honest with themselves and come out. And on the other hand, once they do that, they're demonized for coming out, for being gay, for being honest about who they are. So it's like a catch-22.
Mm-hmm.
So I just think that, you know, the reality is that we have to be honest with ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And if that means being open about who we are and telling the other person what we are, then we have to do that.
Right.
Do you also blame it on what we discussed earlier, that some women want to be married, you know, so bad that they'll take anything, or they just don't, they don't pay attention? Where Andrea's situation was different, you know, whereas though he didn't come off, but I see a lot of women that may have a male friend that they know is openly gay, and they make the decision of, you know, thinking, well, if he wants to marry me, I'll get married just for the sake of companionship. Do you think us women sometimes set ourselves up to be in this predicament?
Yeah.
I think that certainly is a reality.
Absolutely.
I mean, I meet women who know that I'm gay and still, you know, they're flirtatious and, you know, as honest as I am about it.
Right.
But, you know, and I meet women who it's a conquest for them. They think that, well, I can change him.
Yeah.
You know, and the reality is, you can't.
You can't, boo.
Because if it was that good, you wouldn't have been, you know,
right.
like this, that. So, you know, I don't understand why women think that, but I'm glad you said that. So
right.
That if they listening, they can understand.
So I just want to reiterate that in layman's terms, ladies, stop it. What they like is what they like.
You
cannot change them.
You ain't Jesus.
Okay? Move on, please.
So, with
I'm sick of you.
With that being said, you